Right, this is just a, well, just a spontaneous dream. Hope you're doing okay. I decided to play some MediEvil last night. I haven't played it for a while. It's not starting at the beginning or anything. So I thought I'd do it now. I need to get a few supplies up. I'll go in here first. I technically don't need these shields and stuff. That I need. The money I could do with too. I have no choice but to do this one. Scarecrows.
The scarecrows are almost unstoppable, so don't be a hero. If you can't beat them, try trapping them while you make your escape. Using your new Daring Dash ability should help you get ahead of them quickly.
Sure, it's a club. It's the correct weapon to be using. aside from the scarecrows, his enemies aren't too difficult to defeat on their own. But they just keep bloody respawning, that's the problem. Backwards. Stuck in the corner there, that really wasn't worth it, was it? Press the right bloody button to attack, I might get on better.
These fields are home to many mad machines, yet the most bizarre of them is housed within this vial.
Yes, but that didn't take long, did it? At least the gang keeps a bloody, well, the crows still get in, but at least it keeps the other enemies out while you're trying to do these. Don't bother with the bloody with the chest. Come on, give me that rune, I need the rune. This might give me some form of break.
The corn cutting machine is missing a part. A cog fell off this miracle of modern agriculture, and it hasn't worked since.
A shield, and then we've got a club. What is it with the shitty weapons and armor and stuff? You're missing a cog. So that's what I have to figure out. Bit of an issue here, but slight thing with my stream title. Let's have a drink, recuperate the thoughts a bit. The heat on because my feet were cold a little bit earlier, but
in the cornfield. Pick your route carefully and do not linger in the cornfield.
I don't have to go in there, do I? That looks like certain death. I just didn't know way in heck that out of the corn that I was going to be going in there. I'm not dead. I am now. Why did that seem to take such a bloody long time to... do anything? Off me! That silver shield is not worth it. round. Why are these taking me so bloody long this time? Wasting flipping health. That was backwards, but it's probably a good idea that I did that, because that's my health. To get the impression that letting that out probably wasn't the best idea. Just got rid of some of the scarecrows. Quite make it that time. I mean, you bastard. I've also got a sock confusing the weapon change button with the attack button. not helping that. If you can hear the fan noise in the background, I can't do anything about that. I'm using my PS4 to play this this game, and my PS4 has got a heck noisy fan. I don't think they, those crows or whatever they are, respawn, at least not in here. Those other guys do, and okay, what's wrong here? Those other things do, and the scarecrows you can't kill. You definitely don't want to be in there. Trouble is now figuring out which way to let it go. Thanks, Benny. Appreciate that. I appreciate that, Benny. Benny wants me to stop streaming, I think. Yeah. Hey, Benny, eh? Well, guess what, Benny? I'm not going to stop. The thing that was drifting over there. Yeah, all right, Benny. But please, please, Benny, just don't. Bloody screen. Benny! 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 Over here! Over here, Benny! think it was worth doing that for that health. I might have settled Ben with him. I couldn't be. But he does what he wants attention. He goes about it any way he can. Which sometimes includes getting in front of the screen when I'm playing. Wrong side, I need to turn around, no. Wrong side. This isn't helping. Not helping at all. Those scarecrows got caught by the scarecrows. Didn't help. Thank you. These buggers didn't respawn. Wouldn't be anywhere near as bad to dispose of them. That's better, actually hitting him will help. Hallelujah. Let's not get caught by these bloody scarecrows this time. Bats or whatever they are in here. They're the ones that don't respawn. Well, at least not till I come back in. I'll go out and come back in at least. Fell over the other day, landed on the hard floor in the kitchen. It's clever, but one of those things. Right, I got caught up in the wrong place there. And somehow I got turned around and disorientated and messed up and dead. sake. Yeah, I don't need to go back around the other place and get that health thing. Don't let the scarecrows catch you, and yeah, don't let the scarecrows catch you. All the fucking bats. Bit of a cack-handed way of doing it, but out of the fucking horn. I don't normally waste too much time actually trying to kill them because they respawn and stuff, but those two were irritating the shit out of me. Why I went after them like this. I'm gonna try and go out on a limb here. which probably will not work. Oh, I see. I do have to get past this. So I can make progress now. Well, it's done that bit, has it? Progress has been made. Pumpkin Gorge or the Sleeping Spinach. At least I have a couple of options open to me here. I've wanted to go. Savage Pumpkin. Oh, sorry, wrong game. Things back there hurt. If I stick to ranged weapons until I can get some more health. At least these enemies don't appear to be respawning, which is nice. Now, is that the only way to go? Do I have to go into the other place? Which I can't do anyway because I can't get to an exit. Well, I can quit. Quit out of it, but there's got to be a way through somewhere. That or The bloody way past. Well, I can't do anything. Need to be anywhere else to go. Come on out, there must be a reason for it. Kind of feeling like that wall or something. We can stand on the pumpkins. And we need to do the village or whatever it is first. Let's head through there one more time and we'll see if there's anywhere else to go. If not, leave, do the other place first, see if that achieves anything. Hopefully. I'll try the other place first, I can always come back there. Top up my health completely, I think.
Any treasure that you find will be added to your coin total. Coins are used to buy items from the greedy merchant gargoyles.
I'll try the other place. Because clearly can't get anywhere there yet. hell. Oh, great. He doesn't look like he's a friend.
Poor villagers. The master possesses them. It mustn't hurt them. Hurt guards, though. They seek out an object of great power.
Apparently I'm not supposed to hurt these villagers. If they start hurting me...
The rune key is held aloft by the flow of water from the fountain. You may have to wait for the next drought.
Well, can't hurt them. Okay. So I just have to avoid them, which is okay, I guess. Is what it is. Handy to know there's a healing thing in there.
A crucifix once stood here, but the mayor took it. Find a replacement and see how the church should really look.
Right, mummy. Crucifix stood there, but the mayor took it. And these, oh no. Oh no, good soul has been lost. Shit.
Blacksmith's Monday. Old man Willie Green of Gallowstown was awarded Smithy of the Season by our readers. His outstanding casts have produced many intricate and hard-wearing iron goods and sculptures. Willie only uses the finest of metals in his work and is particularly noted for his magnificent busts. Old man Willie was quoted as saying,
"Old man Willie,
when I get pumping on me bellows, there's no stopping me. It's all in the rhythm, up and down, up and down. I've always been inspired by the stories of Stanya Iron Hewer, the greatest smithy there ever was."
Silver shield. In a minute there are going to be more good souls lost. If you don't leave me alone. Moving room, which I don't have. It's not in there, is it? No, it's not. Just had to, use the process of elimination there. Sorry about the good soul lost, but it fell in the water. There's the moon room, isn't it? No. It's not. False alarm.
Bust of Mr. Shanks, landlord of the Troll's Head. To clean the statue, lower the pedestal.
Well, the guards I can kill.
Tear this place apart. If we don't find the shadow artifact, Lord Zarak will have us mocking out the demons for the next millennium.
Well, I knew that wasn't going to last long.
Thank you.
can't remember where that. There's a church. Don't need to be in there at the minute. Where the place opens up was. Oh, no, I've got to go down here. It was well in the first. Hopefully some stupid little rat won't follow me down here this time. Yeah, I know that, I just picked it up. Oh, I need a moon rune for that one. Shit, so. Off me, otherwise you'll die.
A crucifix once stood here, but the mayor took it. Find a replacement and see how the church should really look.
This game needs save states. Just saying. Every game needs save states. What is the option? Use them.
History of Galamir, Volume 3. News that Xerox's army had now taken the bloodlands caused much concern. From this vantage point, Xerox could march west to take the Enchanted Forest. This sacred place would prove a bitter defeat if it fell into the hands of the evil sorcerer. It was Sir Dan Fortescue who once again led the king's militia to rid the demon host from the land. Yet the evil wizard was cunning and had prepared an ambush. Titanic battle ensued, of which history has never seen the like. It is said that the day would have gone to Xerox, but for the skill and valor of one man. Fortescue led the charge deep into the massed ranks of the undead, felling Xerox's bodyguard, the fearful Lord Coddock, and before finally succumbing to his own mortal wounds, slew the traitorous sorcerer with a mighty sweep of his sword. History of Galamir, Volume 1. During the dark time that was Galamir's not too distant past, it was King Peregrine who thwarted Xerox the Necromancer and his plan to enslave the land. Xerox, once the king's mage, had fallen out of favor with the ruler for conducting outlandish experiments on the bodies of the dead. It was said that deep within Peregrine Castle, the dead were restless. The dead are to be honored, not kept as the playthings of alchemists, declared King Peregrine as he banished Xerox from the castle. All of Xerox's living dead were routed out and destroyed. Xerox, being an unforgiving soul, went into hiding and vowed to wreak his revenge on the king.
Yeah.
History of Galamir, Volume 2. Rumors of ill-doing and dark deeds abounded through the land of Galamir. It was whispered that Xerath had employed the aid of shadowy demons to help build a vast castle. Under the cover of night, Xerath's dark army spilled forth from the corrupt haven. The army marched south across the Silver Mountains and through the Silver Woods. Soon afterwards, even the Pumpkin Lands belonged to Xerath. The folk of Gallowstown cried out for help. Save us, good King Peregrine. Retaliation was swift and violent. King Peregrine's forces, led by the brave Sir Fortescue, drove Xerath's army back from Gallowstown. There was much rejoicing, but the war was not yet over. History of Galamir, Volume 4. The forces of Evil were destroyed, but at a terrible price. None but a handful of the King's militia returned from that field. Galamir lost a whole generation of young men, including Colonel Tim, the legendary crossbowman, and Fortescue's second in command, who fell in the first volley of error. Xerath's body was never found. Though if it lies unmourned in an unmarked grave, then no one in Galamir would shed a tear. The shadow demons that had fallen under Xerath's banner were unnatural creatures that did not belong in the world of mortal men. The king declared that they be banished, entombed under the pure earth of the Enchanted Earth, imprisoned within an impregnable box of the king's design. The demons were buried deep underground. Their tomb was sealed with a magical device and has since come to be known as the Shadow Artifact.
I'll tell you what, if these villagers don't leave me alone, regardless of whether they're supposed to die or not, they will.
The land of Galamir is a wondrous land of breathtaking sights and adventure. If it's beauty you are looking for, be sure to check out the sights of the Enchanted Forest. Scale the heights and see the nests of giant dragon birds. Seek out weird and wonderful plant life. Go and ah at the sight of baby dragon toads splashing about in the crystal clear ponds. Why not take a walk through the Pumpkin Valley? Pumpkin is Galamir's favorite dish, and about now the valley is just bulging under the weight of young podlings awaiting harvest. Tourist Guide to Galamir, Part 2. If it's mystery you're looking for, then the seasoned adventurer should travel to the ruins of King Peregrine's castle. Yes, this is the fortress from which the fabled King Peregrine once hailed. It is said that the king's crown was lost in the dungeons below the castle, and that the ghost of the regent himself now haunts these cold stone passageways. Spooky. Why not take the swamps and seek out the mythical town of Melanie? This place was once said to be a place of fantastical art and alchemy, but an age has passed since it was consumed by the murky swamps. Perhaps great treasure awaits any adventurer that can locate its watery resting place. Heroes from History, a retrospective. Chapter 1. In addition to being the strongest man who ever lived, Stanier Iron Hero was unsurpassed in his skill as a blacksmith. He was equally happy pounding on his anvil at home as he was pounding on someone's head in battle.
If I die, I'm not redoing all this again.
His only fear was the end of the village smithy as the focus of manufacture in favor of more centralized units. As if. Chapter 2. Born a humble peasant to one of the nomadic tribes from the east.
What goes through all that? sorry, but you're dead. It's okay, because I probably will be dead soon, so this time I come to do this, he'll be alive again. So the problem with this is they all, it's just chipping at your health constantly. You can't kill them, mustn't kill them, mustn't kill the villagers. Why not? They're trying to kill me. I don't care if they're possessed by some evil lord or whatever he is. I'm not reading all those flipping books again. been nuts, gone completely bonkers. Does there have to be any villagers left? I could just kill all the fuckers. I haven't been down in here and done that bloody thing yet, have I? That was clever. Yeah, I'm not opening all these, reading all these books again, and I'm not, certainly not killing him. I haven't been in the church yet, so remember that. Grab all the money. Don't matter about the shield too much, but it's an altar club anyway. Don't matter about stuff I've already got. Yeah, or I'll have to kill you. I've got to go back out and go find the church quickly. Where's the mill? The little brats are not cute or funny. Look past here. If you don't stop hitting me, you die. I don't care if you're a good soul, you will die. Well, ideally, I don't want chipping away at my health constantly, but it's going to happen, eh? Possessed or not, you'll die if you don't stop it. If I can't get away from you, we'll continually can't do this. I have to rethink my strategy. Figure out how harmful it would actually be to just let you die. Figure out where I need to go next. There's a fucking guard here. Game over for the guards. I wish. All right, Benny. wonder how bad it'd be just to kill all the villagers. See, that way they wouldn't keep chipping at your bloody health all the time, would they? Don't think that I wasn't. Yeah, duck a few villagers out. If they're attacking me in the moment, then they can die. This guy was very, very close to dying just then. Where's the damn church? I'll be right back. Let's take a minute. Right and back. Right. Now, you died last time you came down here.
The rune key is held aloft.
The trouble is I cannot memorize where everything is here.
I suppose the more times I keep dying and the more times I have to keep doing this. The more times I have to keep doing this, the more I'll memorise where things are. Right, there's a house up here, isn't it?
Oh, well, you will die. I'm not even joking now. Like I said, possessed or not, they're still incredibly irritating, and will be incredibly dead. And I guess I'll find out if it's any advantage whatsoever in keeping them alive. Very careful of these guards this time. Was it too close to Nemicus? What if I should change to a crossbow? I'm 100% sure what to do now.
arsehole. At least you'd have to deal with those guards now. Use a crossbow on them. Don't charge at them with the sword and get too close to them, and don't use those piddling throwing knives on them. I haven't been in the church yet, so I'm careful. I'll go in there, unless I really have to. There's more trouble than it was worth. What is there? Was somebody stuck? Yeah, I've not been in the church yet, so remember this. Unless you want to die, get out of my way. You too, idiot. Maybe I have to go to church after I've done this.
Okay, there's another guard somewhere. Church, church, church. Oh, another guard, another guard. I wonder if the off chance that breast I got would suffice.
A crucifix once stood here, but the mayor.
I guess not. It's my baby. Well, items wouldn't be able to be used there, would they? Thank you. don't want this arsehole to corner me again. But the arsehole's gone. Didn't use that many crossbow bolts really, did I? Stay away from him for sure. Must be a way to get in here. The fact you can jump up places like that, either that's a major glitch or that means that there are places I can go, fuck off! There are places I can go, I mean. Bet that bust is used in here. If this guy is too much trouble, he's dead.
Only way I can face I can think of. I might have to just kill that guy so I can investigate properly. Otherwise I'm not going to be able to debug at all. In there. It's the pub. Gotta be in here.
Heroes from history. A retro. Turisca. Tourist.
Or perhaps it's not in here. Oh, jumping the belly.
Better just kill all the villagers. Yeah, I'm supposed to, but maybe I should.
Tourist guide. Tourist guide.
But where this bus goes. Maybe. I can find the right area. Shit. Knocking stuff. I just have no idea. This guy's gonna be next. Had to kill the other guy, this guy'll be next. I hurt the guards, I hurt all the guards. Regrettably, I had to kill the guy in here. Hope he wasn't anybody important.
Tourist guide to...
Oh, I don't bloody know. Unfortunately, I've killed the guy in there, but I think I know what I have to do. Hope he wasn't anybody important.
Tourist guide.
Stuff I haven't done. I do know how to get that far, I do know what to do to get up to there. But I think there's stuff. In here that I haven't done.
Welcome back to your beloved Galamir.
the stinking dead have risen up to dance with the lifeless living. And they want to do it over your
dead body.
Remember. The object here is the chalice. Every time you dispatch an enemy with a sword, the chalice fills a little nook. The living world lies beyond these skull gates. The master of the hilltop mausoleum, the stained glass demon, has been.
I also get the impression that I'm very under leveled for what I am, for where I need to go next. Yeah, well, that was a shop up there.
Just because of what a sod it would be to actually die here.
Free to have a paddle in the shallow water, but don't be tempted to go for a swim. Buoyancy can be a problem for those of a dead disposition.
One way out. In some of these places, I can play them again and get different ways out of them. Which might help. In fact, I'm pretty sure that is what I need to do. Thank you. This feels different than last time. But it's not. So remember this. See, the problem is, it was a long time since I played it. I started it, played it once, maybe twice. Instead of starting it again, I just continued. So that's why I'm so underleveled, I think.
Remember, nothing remains hidden under the gaze of an angel.
It would have been really, really bad to die here. You know, just wouldn't be good. Some healing going on.
Softly, Zarek awaits beyond these gates. the master meets with the demon from the mausoleum. Hatching plots of purest evil. Forgotten nobodies would be wise to make themselves scarce.
Well, I'm going to have to stop, I think, now. Torn whether I wanted to or not. But, yeah. I'll be back sometime. Thank you for being here. And I'll see you soon. Have a good one.